Demonstrating the capabilities of Jython scripts in FDME in a single video is a difficult task, as the options that scripts enable are so broad in scope. For this demonstration, I'm going to showcase one possible use of scripts to give you an idea of the sort of effects that can be achieved, but do bear in mind that the scope of what can be achieved is very broad indeed. So for this example, we first need to examine the standard FDME export process. You can see here that I'm on the data load workbench in FDME and that I've previously imported and validated some source data which is ready to be exported to HFM. Note that this was done here for the Texas location, and that Texas location relates to the KT demo target application. The reason that this is important is that when the standard export process runs, it will create a .dat file in native HFM format. And that file gets stored in FDME's Outbox folder for this target application. So I've got the Outbox folder here, but you can see that beneath our main application directory, there's a subfolder for each target application, and then beneath that we have an Outbox folder. And it's here that a .dat file will be created when the export is performed. So if I return to the workbench, and I run through the export process now, I'll just confirm those default options. And we should see this .dat file being created here inside of this Outbox folder. Okay, so there's our .dat file, ktdemo304.dat. And note that the 304 simply relates to the process ID that you'll see on the process details screen. But the load that's been done is a very small load. You can see that it's actually only produced 3 lines of data to be loaded to HFM. And for each of these, we have a set of member references separated by semicolon characters. So I'll close this file down, and then I'll talk about how we might want to extend this process using scripts. So to try and showcase the capabilities of scripts here, I've prepared a simple script which will prepare an additional file when the export process is run. It will take all of the details that are used for the .dat file here, but it will create a secondary copy which uses fewer fields inside of the file, and it uses a different delimiter. And this could then be used to load data into a secondary proprietary system, for example, in addition to loading the data into HFM. Rather than producing this file manually after the creation of this .dat file, we can allow FDME to take care of this for us by writing a script which will format the details in the appropriate manner. So you'll see here that I've got an event scripts folder, and I've created a script here called aft-export-to-dat.py. Now we're not going to examine this script for the moment. As we move through the course, we will first familiarize you with Jython syntax and the overall layout of scripts in FDME, before then moving on to evaluating and then writing some more complex examples. So we will be having a look at this later on in the course, but for the moment I'm just going to copy this script, and I'm going to bring that into FDME. Now I could look to register the script through the web interface in FDME, but it's actually quicker for me to move this directly into the correct location in the FDME folder structure. Once again, we're going to go through full details about where scripts are stored and how best to manage this sort of process. But for the moment, I'm going to skip ahead and do this. So I'll return to my KT demo folder for the target application. We'll go into its data subfolder, followed by scripts, followed by event. And I'm going to paste the script into here. As I say, I will give a full tour around the folder structure and where different sorts of detail are stored in a subsequent demonstration. But simply by pasting this script into this folder now, this will execute automatically after the export stage has been processed. So if I again return to the Outbox folder for this application, and I'll return to the web interface and rerun the process, and what we should see is an additional file created as well as the standard .dat file used by HFM. So I'm going to return to the workbench and I'll click the export option to rerun this process, and then I'll return to the Outbox so that we can await the status of this operation. Okay, so another process has been triggered here. We now have a 305.dat file. So you see that number has just been incremented by one on the previous process. And this is the HFM data once more in the same format as we saw earlier. In addition to this file though, we now have a second .dat file with a suffix of edited copy. And you can see that in this copy of the file, we have the same data values as we used in the original .dat file for use by HFM. It's just that these have been reformatted and changed slightly from the original format. Notice that fewer of the dimension details are referenced here, so we've created a subset of those metadata references in effect. Notice that the ordering of the dimensions is different from the original .dat file, and that a different delimiter is used here as well. These are all pretty simple changes made to that original .dat file format. However, this might be the format that was required by some secondary system, and so this would allow us to pick up the file from here and load it into that system in addition to HFM. So although this is a bit of a trivial example, hopefully it gives you an idea for the sorts of things that we can achieve with scripts. We can work with files, we can connect to databases, and we can alter the standard FDME process in pretty fundamental ways by using these scripts. So this is just one small, simple example of the use of scripts and the sorts of things that we can do with them. And as we move through the course, we'll see many, many more examples of these sorts of effects that can be achieved.